Pleasant good morning and praise the Lord. Welcome to each of you and to our worship service this morning. Our call to worship we will share together in unison. It will be on the screen. Call to worship is taken from Psalm chapter 119, verses 89 through 90, 97 and 98, and 102 and 105. This is our call to worship. Your eternal word, O Lord, stands firm in heaven. Your faithfulness extends to every generation. As enduring as the earth you created. Oh, how I love your instructions. I think about them all day long. Your commands make me wiser than my enemies, for they are my constant guide. I haven't turned away from your regulations, for you have taught me well. How sweet your words taste to me. They are sweeter than honey. Your commandments give me understanding. No wonder I hate every false way of life. Your word is a lamp to guide my feet and a light for my path. Amen. Our opening hymn this morning is Jesus Calls Us on the Call.
Jesus calls us from the virgin, of the babe was born, from each other.
thank you for this day, and thank you for your many blessings. May we each one give attention to responding to and being responsible for the lessons that we learn, the things that you teach us. And may we continue in this day and in the days going forward to have a steadfast faith in you, our Father in heaven, and to know and to have an assurance of your presence with us, even in these confusing and difficult times. We pray for those facing challenges. We pray for each of us that you would provide and that your blessings would be realized. We pray for strength. We pray for hope. We pray for faith. In Jesus' name. See the picture staring back at me from this camera where it froze. It's like this. Oh boy. All right. Praise the Lord anyhow for his many blessings and goodness to us. Our next item is our responsive scripture reading that will be on the screen this morning, taken from Matthew chapter 13, verses 1 through 9, and then from verses 18 through 23. And we will read this alternately or responsively. I will read the part that says leader. You will respond in unison with the part that says people, because you are the people. And we are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Amen?
Amen.
All right. Later that same day, Jesus left the house and sat beside the lake. A large crowd soon gathered around him. So he got into a boat, and he sat there and calmed as the people stood on the shore. He told them a story in the form of parables, such as this one. Listen, a farmer went out to plant some seeds. As he scattered them across his field, some seeds fell on a footpath, and the birds came and ate them. Other seeds fell on shallow soil with underlying rock. The seeds sprouted quickly because the soil was shallow, but the plants soon wilted under the hot sun, and since they didn't have deep roots, they died. Other seeds fell among thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still other seeds fell on fertile soil, and they produced a crop that was 30, 60, and even 100 times as much as they planted. Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand. Now, listen to the explanation of the parable about the farmer planting seeds. The seed that fell on the footpath represents those who hear the message about the kingdom and don't understand. And then the evil one comes and snatches away the seed the seed that fell on good soil, represents those who truly hear and understand God's word and produce a harvest of 30, 60, or even 100 times as much as had been planted. This is God's word for us today.
God's peace of God.
I'm going to share with you a little something different this morning. Because I've been contemplating a lot lately. Anybody else been contemplating lately? I think we all have been in a spirit and attitude of some type of contemplation. Sometimes, maybe some of us are overcomplicated. What do you think? Sometimes maybe we think too much. Sometimes maybe we have been so bombarded by so much and so many different things that are clanging and clattering around in our minds. It's a wonder we're not walking around dizzy and stumbling because there's just so much. And so many things are happening and so many people saying different things, and so many people telling us do this, don't do that, don't do this, don't do the next thing, and then the next week it changes completely. I want to present to you this morning, and I think see, the Lord is even telling me to be quiet. It's time for us it's time for us to take a break. It's time for a pause, if you will, in our individual lives. It's time for some silence and some quiet. Phyllis Diller, the comedian, said, we spend the first 12 months of our children's lives teaching them to walk and talk, and the next 12 telling them to sit down and shut up. Will Rogers said, never miss a chance to shut up. That's a term that even in our household growing up, we didn't use. Shut up. It was be quiet or it was hush. But I think you understand I'm quoting other people, and even though I may not use those words personally, those are words that are in those books. I want to share with you this morning some passages of Scripture from a variety of different places that talk to us about this idea and concept of a need to quiet ourselves, of a need to be still, of a need to, I don't know if you remember a commercial from years ago for a product called Calmon, which is some kind of a bath thing. And this lady, after the end of her busy day with the kids and the chores and work, come home and say, Calgon, take me away. And that was her time to relax and to think and to process. And sometimes we are so bombarded by what's going on in our world around us that we don't even have time with our busy schedules and with everything that we have to do. And even in this time of shutdowns and quarantines and stay-at-home orders and all of these things, there's still so much that can occupy our minds because we still have telephones, we still have television, we still have the internet. One of the things I praise God for in the midst of all of this has been the night curfews. Amen? Can I hear amen? The night curfews. Man, it has been so nice at night to not hear the boom, boom, thump, 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 bang, bang, all of that stuff. And I'm honestly not looking forward to the time when the curfews are lifted and things go back, because it has just been so nice to have a much more quieter atmosphere in our lives in these days. Let me share with you from Psalms chapter 46, verses 1 through 11. God is our refuge and strength, always ready to help in times of trouble. So we will not fear when earthquakes come and the mountains crumble into the sea. Let the oceans roar and foam. Let the mountains tremble as the waters surge. A river brings joy to the city of our God, the sacred home of the Most High. God dwells in that city. It cannot be destroyed. From the very break of day, God will protect it. The nations are in chaos. Boy, that's not a true statement. I don't know what is it. The nations are in chaos, and their kingdoms crumble. God's voice thunders, and the earth melts. The Lord of heaven's armies is here among us. The God of Israel is our fortress. Come. See the glorious works of the Lord. See how he brings destruction upon the world. He causes wars to end throughout the earth. He breaks the bow and snaps the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be honored by every nation. I will be honored throughout the world. The Lord of heaven's armies is here among us. The God of Israel is our fortress. Just process that. Think about the beginning of that passage of Scripture so clearly describes what's going on around us. The turmoil, the earthquakes, the mountains crumbling into the sea, the oceans roar and foam. There is a river that brings joy to the city of our God. I don't know about you, but why? Battling work. A waterfall, the sound of the waves on the shore, can bring such peace to our troubled souls. The nations are in chaos. Really? Boy, that's the truth. The nations are in chaos. The nations. And their kingdoms crumble. Three words right there in the world we live in today. The nations are in chaos and kingdoms are crumbling. And it is yet to be determined which kingdom is going to be the one on this earth that is left standing at the end of all of this chaos that our nations are in today. But one thing. And that is, there is one nation that will not crumble. There is one nation that will not fall. There is one kingdom that is going to last and remain forever, and that is the kingdom of my God. And because of that, we have the ability to take refuge in the God of the heavens. Come and see the glorious works of the Lord. See how he brings destruction upon the world. He causes wars to end throughout the earth. still imply confidence in me. This morning, I hope that we each can find some way of finding some peace, of finding some respite, of finding some respite, of finding some stillness that will allow us to have a clearer understanding of who God is and how great His promises are to us. Another passage along the same kind of theme, Psalm 37, verses 1 through 7. It says, "Don't worry about the wicked or envy those who do wrong. For like grass, they will soon fade away. Like spring flowers, they soon wither. Trust in the Lord and do good. Then you will live safely in the land and prosper. Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you your heart's desires. Commit everything you do to the Lord. Trust in Him, and He will help you. He will make your innocence radiate like the dawn, and the justice of your cause will shine like the noonday sun. Be still in the presence of the Lord, and wait patiently for Him to act. Don't worry about evil people who prosper or fret about their wicked schemes." Man, aren't there times when you just look at what's going on around you and, I don't know about you, but sometimes I just get angry. I get frustrated. I get upset. I get concerned about what's happening and what's going to end up happening. And yet we have God who is telling us in these times that we are to put our faith and trust in Him. Have patience. Really? Have patience. And wait for Him to act. Like Peter in the garden. You know, Peter had come to arrest Jesus. And Peter waited patiently to act, didn't he? Not so much. Peter said, "Well, no, this isn't going to happen." And pulls out a sword and whacks off the servant's ear. That's not waiting patiently for the Lord to act. That's taking matters into our own hands. And sometimes some of us may wish that we could take matters into our own hands, even in the midst of what's going on today. Well, I can straighten this thing out. Let me at him. What are we waiting for? And yet, in the midst of this, God says to us in Psalm 37, "Don't worry about the wicked or envy those who do wrong, because they're like the grass that'll fade and the flower that'll wilt. Their time is coming, and they will be dealt with. Trust in the Lord and do good." We need to stop. Boy, this is a sermon for Pastor Dave this morning. We need to stop being so concerned about what other people are doing and what other things are going on in the world around us, and be more concerned about what God is doing in the midst of all of this. Because last time I checked, He's still on the throne, and He's still in control of what's going on. And yet there are times when we, remember when I point fingers out there, and there's three more pointing times, the only time I'm a patient is when I go to the doctor. But we're encouraged to be patient and wait for him to act and not worry about the evil people who prosper or fret about their wicked sins. Ecclesiastes 3:1-8 says, for everything there is a season, a time for every activity under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to harvest, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up, a time to cry and a time to laugh, a time to grieve and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather stones, a time to embrace and a time to turn away, a time to search and a time to quit searching, a time to keep and a time to throw away, a time to tear and a time to mend.
Mark chapter 1.
1, 12 and 13, it says, "At once the Spirit sends Jesus out into the desert, and he was in the desert 40 days being tempted. He was with the wild animals, and angels attended him." Sometimes we need to get off the beaten path. We need to go out into the wildness of the wilderness. And we need to allow the Spirit of God to speak to us through the nature that is around us and by his angels attending us and by the presence of his Spirit. Mark chapter 1:35, it says, "Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed." Luke 5:16, Jesus often withdrew to lonely places and prayed. Luke 6:12-13, Jesus went out to a mountainside to pray and spent the night praying to God. When morning came, he called his disciples to him and chose 12 of them. Luke 11:1-2. One day Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen." Matthew 14:13. When Jesus heard what had happened, that John the Baptist was beheaded, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the towns. John 6:15, Jesus, knowing that they intended to come and make him king by force, withdrew again to a mountain by himself. Matthew 11:28-30, Jesus said to his disciples and a crowd of people, "Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden." And you ever feel like you just need rest for your weary soul? Your soul ever just get, you just get plain, I don't even know what word, beside yourself. Matthew 17:1-2, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, the brother James, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. There he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became as white as the light. If Jesus needed to get away, if Jesus needed to go and take some rest, find places of solitude, we still can. Even going as far as going off and praying all night. What makes us think that we are exempt from it? What makes us think that we can handle everything that is happening? energize our money has a limit. And even you and me have limits to what we can do if we do not recharge. What happens to your cell phone when the battery gone? Dead. And unless you recharge that battery in that phone, it's going to be dead. And it's of no use to you except to pay for it. And we, in our spiritual lives, have batteries that become worn down and worn out. We have in our, even in our way of thinking, we have processes in our minds that need to turn off. We need sleep. We need to recharge our physical batteries and our spiritual batteries and our emotional batteries. Or we will be like that dead cell phone, nothing more than a paper which should occupy space. Psalm chapter 23. Says the Lord is my shepherd, I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along the right paths, bringing honor to his name. And even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. You prepare a feast for me in the presence of my enemies. You honor me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessings. Surely your goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live house of the Lord forever. It's time for us to be still and know that He is. thank you for your promise of rest, even for those who are weary. Father, as we contemplate all that is going on around us, as we are faced with so many trials and so many concerns and so many life events and so much confusion and so much misunderstanding and so much conflict and just those things alone could tire us out, could wear us out, and bring a weariness to our minds, our bodies, and our souls. Father in heaven, we pray that you would give us the wisdom to find times in which we can seek you in silence and solitude, in quietness and stillness. That you would renew us, refresh us, and restore us by the power of your Spirit working within us. Father, we thank you for the example of your Son, Jesus, our Savior, who himself was not immune to the need for solitude and quiet and seeking you and spending time in your presence. Father, may we follow his example as he in his perfection still required solitude and may we also realize that in our limited humanity, that we too need rest for our weary souls. Father, would you help us to incorporate periods and times of quiet, of stillness, of contemplating you and your greatness, and your plan and purpose in our lives and for the world around us. Father, would you take the heavy yoke that we bear? Would you release us from the burdens we carry? And would you renew our strength? Restore our faith. Refresh our spiritual life. Father, this morning we pray especially for those who are going through difficulties by way of physical ailments or illness, for those that are dealing with grieving the loss of a loved one, for those that are in a unknown situation because of finances and jobs and all that is happening around us. For those that are fearful, Father, we pray that you would give them your spirit of love and of grace and of peace and of a sound mind. Father, that we would be able to bear up underneath all of the things that are affecting our lives in these moments, with an awareness and an understanding that you are still in control, that you are still the God of the universe, and that we can put our faith and our please contact